This is a quick video on the LoRA release for the Qwen edit model. I have made multiple workflows for the respective LoRA. Let's look at the first LoRA, the Qwen edit fusion. For this example, I have used an image of a remote control toy car from Amazon, and below is the image of a street. Let's look at the files used in this workflow. I am using the FPA diffusion model, and on the left, I have the links to all the files. This link should take us to the Qwen edit model present on the Hugging Face page. This is the larger diffusion model, and below is the smaller FP8 model, which I will be using. A direct download link for the same FP8 model is given here, and below is the link to the GGUF models. If you have a 12 GB or smaller card, you can download GGUF models from here. Larger models may work if you have enough system RAM, but then the generation time will be longer. So, you really need to try these models by yourself to find the best for your system. Next is the Lightning LoRA, and you can get it from here. I have given the direct download link to the LoRA I will be using in the example. The 4-step LoRA is fast, but if you want quality, get the 8-step LoRA. After Lightning LoRA, there is this Fusion LoRA, which is the reason for making this video. This link will take you to comfyUI on Hugging Face. And this is the Fusion LoRA, uploaded 7 days ago. Other LoRA are also being uploaded, which we will be looking at later. The Fusion LoRA was also uploaded by a different user, and this is the direct download link. You will need to rename the file if you do not understand this text. I have given the link of this user, in case you want to check. Next is the text encoder, and this is a 16 GB file, which is large for my system. I will be using this FP8 file. Last is the VAE, and the folder structure for the files are given below. And in case you're using the GGUF models, then keep the model inside the UNET folder. So that was the files required, and the same are selected in these red color notes. This node above is for the GGUF models. Disconnect this node, and connect this GGUF node directly, then you should be good with GGUF models. The workflow is simple, but this prompt may not be simple to some viewers. The prompt you saw was the trigger words. And below is the Google translation of the same text. This image upload section may confuse beginners, so I will explain it quickly. This toy car image is the foreground on this background. I will bypass the k-samper so that I can adjust the foreground and background first. Here the background of the car will be removed and then the image will be combined with the background. The preview should be visible here when I run the workflow. So, the background was removed and the car was placed on the given background. The node which combines the image has few options, like this opacity, decreasing this will make the car transparent. Next is the foreground scale. Keeping the value as 1 should bring the car to its original size. 0.40 looks correct in this example. Next is the X and Y axis, which positions the car on the background. If I change the value of X axis and make it 10, then run the workflow. The car is now positioned on the left of the image. This means the X axis is on the top. It goes like 10, 20, 30, 40, and so on. Next, I will decrease the Y axis, which is on the left side of the image. And it starts from the top. 10, 20, 30, 40, and so on. This background image with a resize node will maintain the image size under 1024 pixels with the aspect ratio of the given image. The combined image goes to the positive and negative nodes, and it is also used as a latent image for the result. Here, I have an option to give an empty latent image as well, but I prefer giving the combined image for the best results. Once you are done with the foreground and background image, activate these nodes and run the workflow. Try using the 8-step LoRA for better results, The four-step LoRA took 47 seconds on my 4060 Ti 16GB card. And with a few clicks, I was able to make the toy car appear in the neighborhood. I tried a few more images, like this hand wash image. And I was looking for soap, but then I took this bottle. The bottle is uploaded. I had to make changes here to adjust the size and position. And this is the hand. And this is the combined image. The result looks good, and if this looks disfigured, then it's not. This is from the original image. The image generated will not be correct all the time. This will give you a bad result like this. The AI here was not able to find the human body shape, so it failed. A short sleeve t-shirt worked because the hands and width of the body was visible. This section looks bad. We should be able to fix this using a prompt. As per the LoRA details, the given trigger words are in Chinese, so I have to use Google Translation and paste a Chinese prompt. But then I pasted the prompt in English and ran the workflow. The image generated looks better. The t-shirt around his right hand has some problems which can be fixed. And it is good to know that the prompt works in both languages. Now let's quickly look at another LoRA, and the workflow for the same is below. The models and Lightning LoRA used are the same. So I will copy the links and activate the workflow. The LoRA is named as Light Migration. This is the LoRA on Hugging Face, and below are some of the use cases shown. I have updated the link here. The LoRA is uploaded by a different user we saw above. This is the direct download link, and you will have to rename the file after download. I have renamed the file as lightmigration.safetensor. The remaining files selected are the same as above. The workflow is simple, and the subject here is this woman working. The second image is the reference of light to be replicated. The prompt you see here is from the instructions given on the Hugging Face. After the translation, I can see the text says about removing the light from image 1, which should be the woman's image. Then relighting the same image with reference to the second image, which is the skeleton on the motorbike. I will run the workflow, but the run button seems to be hiding here. The first image took 90 seconds to generate, and the image looks good. The prompt was about light and hue, which has been referred from the given image. The background is dark. The image looks great to me. When using this workflow, make sure the image of the main subject is uploaded in this node. Because the empty latent given to the K-sampler should match the aspect ratio for a decent result. I am using the empty latent image, but I can also give the woman's image to the K-sampler and run the workflow to see the difference. The time taken to generate the second image was 50 seconds, and the result looks similar. I will try again with a different light. And it took 60 seconds to generate the image. The light looks natural with the same pattern for the given image. But is this really the LoRA? Or is this the doing of Qwen edit model? To check, I bypassed the LoRA node and generated the image again. The time taken to generate the image was 47 seconds, and the light falling on the table is missing now. So the lighting effect we saw was the working of LoRA and not the Qwen edit model. There are a few more LoRA I wanted to cover, but now I need to end this video due to my work. I will continue this video later. The workflow you saw will be in the Discord group and in the description. Thanks for watching. I wish you a great day ahead.